Friends, in this session, I'm going to talk about the expense recognition and the inventory expense recognition that are used in the company, okay, in any company for that matter. So let us first see the concept of expense recognition. Expenses are generally subtracted from revenue to arrive at the net income. So it is a reduction in economic benefit, okay? It is a reduction or decrease of economic benefit in the way of or in the method of cash outflow, then asset depletion, then incurrence of liability, okay? So there are basically two ways in expense recognition that are used. One is the in the accrual method it is used, that is the when suppose any expense has incurred in the last quarter of any year, that is fourth quarter of any year, but the revenue has been collected with respect to that particular expense, that has been revenue has been collected in the first quarter of the next year. So both the revenue and the related cost will be shown in the next year's first quarter, not in the last year's last quarter, okay? So that is the matching principle concept, okay? Here where the both the expense and the related revenue that is generated, they are shown in the same period of time, okay? But this doesn't happen all the time, okay? There are certain costs which has to be shown, those costs have to be shown in the same period as that of occurrence. Those are known as periodic cost, okay? Like say for example, administrative cost, it doesn't get carry forward, rather it has to be shown on the very period where it has actually incurred. So that is concept of expense recognition. Now we will see the inventory expense recognition. Actually there are three methods that are used widely. They are first in first out, known as shortly known as FIFO, then last in first out, LIFO, and then weighted average method, okay? So in first in first out, what happens, the earliest purchased inventory will be sold out first and the recently purchased unit will be taken out at the end, okay? So here the cost of goods sold generally consists of the earliest purchased inventory, okay, and the ending inventory will be the recently purchased inventory, okay? And this method is basically used by the food companies because they do not want to keep their items or inventory earliest purchased good, they cannot keep it for a long time because they will go waste, and they always want to keep the items fresh, okay? So FIFO is used by the food companies generally. Then we will see the last in first out. What happens in last in first out is the most recently purchased items or inventories will be sold out first, okay, and the earliest purchased inventory will be sold out last. So here the cost of goods sold will be consisting of the recently purchased inventory and the ending inventory will be the earliest purchased inventory, okay? And this particular LIFO is used by generally like say for example the coal distributor, because coal doesn't deteriorate as and when the time passes, okay? So that is LIFO. LIFO gives a tax benefit because in an inflationary situation the cost of the this recently purchased units are higher, then that gives a reduced income, then it ultimately it gives a reduced tax. I mean the tax benefit will be given by this because the tax income will be reduced, then the tax also tax amount will be reduced, so in that way it will give a tax benefit. Next we will see the weighted average method. Weighted average will be calculated by dividing the total cost divided by the total number of units, okay? So the we'll call the average cost per unit, okay? Here it doesn't follow any sequence as such because the flow of the inventory you can use as per your convenience. So here the the average cost of inventory and the ending inventory lies between the LIFO and the FIFO. That is, the range is between the LIFO and the FIFO. So yeah, that is about the inventory expense recognition, and we saw the expense recognition concept as well. Thank you very much. In the coming session, we will see more about the various expense recognition methods. Thank you very much.